This is a worrying and a testing time for us and for everybody around the world. In a very short space of time, daily life has changed rapidly and dramatically as self-isolation and social distancing has become the new norm. For monks, social distancing and self-isolation ought to be something that's very easy, but we're not cut off from the concerns of the outside world. We're very concerned, of course, about our own health, about the health of the elderly and the more sick members of our community, but we're especially concerned about the health and the well-being of you, our students, our staff, of your family, and of your friends. In these days, life's big questions are really at the forefront of all of our minds. We're starting to realise how vulnerable we are as human beings. We're starting to think about things like suffering, about big questions of life and death. In these days, we are praying especially for all of you. And in these days, there's an opportunity for all of us to pray especially for ourselves and for each other, for those who are sick and for those who are caring for them, for world leaders, and especially for all those who have died. It's an opportunity in these days ahead to grow more deeply in our relationship with God and in our relationship with each other. These are not days that can be wasted in self-isolation. Of course, we have our studies to do, but we can use this as a time, especially during Lent, to grow in our relationship with God. I hope in the days ahead, we'll be able to pray for each other as we pray now, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In these final days of Lent, I pray that God will hear and accept our prayer, our fasting, and our charity. And I wish you all every blessing and good health.